What are the problems that developers face with the data while doing projects in Power BI? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from KNOWHOW Academy. In this video, we are going to see what are the different data sources available in Power BI, how the data will be received from the client, difference between structured and unstructured data, challenges with the data in real time using Power BI, and importance of relationships between tables in Power BI. Let's consider there is a huge amount of data that you have to work on, and it has multiple tables, multiple columns, and other stuff in it. So for example, I have two data sets here, two data. One is a data table, another one is a product table. So I have multiple rows and I have multiple columns in it. So here, when these kind of multiple rows and multiple columns are there, this data is having very less columns and very less rows. But in real time, when you are working, you will be having some thousands and millions of rows and millions of columns. So it is a primary responsibility of a Power BI developer to know whether the data is clean or unclean, and if the data is structured or unstructured. So for example, if in this particular data set, if we go and check whether our data is clean or unclean, how can we do that? If we see here in Power Query Editor, which is inbuilt transformations that we have in Power BI. So if you see, the column is 100% valid. So there are no errors. There are no empty informations in this particular thing. But here, if you see, there is something called as error. This is unclean data. Okay, we have 100% errors here. There is 0% empty information. Yes, but there is 0% valid information also. So this kind of data is unclean data. If we still look into it, we have two columns which are completely empty. So there is no information in it. And these kind of informations will be more when we receive the data that we have to work on in the projects. So now the point is, it is a responsibility of a Power BI developer to know and understand whether this data is clean or unclean, or if the data is structured or unstructured. Some rows will be converted into columns and columns will be converted into rows. So we need to check with it. Now we have multiple different data sources. So whichever the data source, either that might be SQL, whether that might be Excel, in whichever format we receive the data from the client, it's a challenging part to get all the data into Power BI and start analyzing it. Power BI is one of the best business intelligence tools in the market today. There's no doubt in it, but still it has many and many challenges every developer faces while working on a project. So here, these kind of challenges will be really existing in the company. Yes, it will be existing in the company. It will be there in every data that we have received from the client. Power BI, it extracts the data from 99 plus different data sources. So what are those 99 plus data sources? We have multiple data sources that Power BI can extract the data from. If we see here in Power BI desktop, there is an option called Get Data, and if we click on More, we can see lot of data sources that Power BI can extract the data from, such as Excel, text file, XML, SQL, MySQL, Snowflake, Azure. So there are multiple data sources. All these are 99 plus different data sources where Power BI can extract the data from. But the first challenge is, what if you are getting the data from multiple data sources? So let's consider I have received two data sets, one from Excel sheet and another from SQL server. So when I'm trying to get all those two data sets, as how I have got my data and product data here into my Power BI desktop, what happens if there is no mapping among the data? What is mapping among the data? So for example, I have this particular data table and I have something called as product table. If there is no relation between these two tables, if there is no mapping between these two tables, you cannot create a visual. You cannot have disconnected tables. For example, as in the model view, you can see we have a data table and we have a product table. There is a relationship in between these two tables. And the condition to have a relationship is we need to have at least one common column to connect with two different tables. Now, every table must be connected for better business understanding. You may not have a proper mapping while you receive the data set. So here, if I remove this particular relationship, it is highly impossible that I can prepare a visual by getting the information or getting the columns from these two different tables. We cannot have two disconnected tables. Every table must be connected for better business understanding. Every table must be connected with each other. You may not have a proper mapping while we receive it. Now I do not have a proper mapping. How can you find the right relationship, whether it is one-to-one relationship, one-to-many relationship, many-to-many relationship, or many-to-one relationship? How can we find out this relationship status? So here we have an option called as manage relationship. Once we click on manage relationship, we need to choose the tables that we have. One table is data and my second table is product data. So by default, it has considered the common column, which is our serial ID. Now, as I told you, we have many to one relationship, one to one relationship, one to many relationship, many to many relationship. Power BI will by default consider the relationship between two tables. So if you would like to change the relationship, you can do it, but it depends upon the data. It depends upon the requirement. So let me click on OK. And I'll click on close. So there is a relationship which is built between two particular data sets. This is one of the challenges that every organization is facing with. As I have only two tables, it's fine. I can clearly show you how we can create the relationship. But the point is, when we receive the data sets from multiple data sources, for example, I have received it from XML, from CSV, from Excel, and from SQL. Now, I have to bring all these into my particular Power BI and start connecting it. And I have to map it. So we cannot expect that we receive the ready-made data, everything mapped, everything structured, everything clean. We will not get it. We have to use Power BI. We have to clean it as I have shown it to you in Power Query Editor. We have to, for example, these two columns are null information. There is no information in it. I have to remove it. Right click and remove it. So I have removed one column. So like this, we need to clean it. We need to do the transformations. We need to do the modeling part. It is a Power BI developer's responsibility. Now let's say you get the data and now you are trying to create a mapping. The next challenge is you might face that the data is incomplete. So when I have my complete information, the data is incomplete. As you can see, there are multiple errors in this particular data set. In the column by name, by customer contact number, I have multiple errors. There might be some null informations. So that this data is incomplete. How do you find it incomplete if you don't understand the business? So we need to understand the business or business requirements to know whether my data is clean or my data is unclean. In every organization, this is one of the challenges that everyone are facing with. So whatever we are doing in Power BI, we are doing it in a structured data only, but how to do using unstructured data without clearing the data, without making the data clean, without making the column 100% valid and meet the client's requirement, we cannot start preparing the report, others will get the negative values. So this is always going to be a challenge whenever you are working in a real-time companies. So once when we have our columns 100% clean, no errors, no empty informations, then that can be called as a clean data. So if the rows are in a proper format, if the columns are in a proper format, everything is structured, then we can start working on a report. So whenever it is required for a person, for a developer to use DAX function in implementation part, I'm not talking about analyzing part. DAX, it stands for data analysis expression. Whenever we are using this DAX function in the implementation part, it plays a very important role in our project. So for example, I have received some 10 particular columns from my client. Now the requirement to prepare a report that client has given it to me, in that we don't have information from the data set that we have received, what we need to do? We have to use the DAX functions and we have to calculate it and we have to get the result out of it. It provides a lot of features, a lot of calculations based upon the business requirements. So thank you for choosing KNOWHOW Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any queries, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious, keep learning.